funny.
All right, we're going to have more highlights of our first 6 months throughout the show, but now let's send it over to Kit.
It's going to be all Jay, all Petra, all day long. All right, thanks, guys. It sounds like a high school prank as part of the opening of the San Diego Padres' new stadium, Petco Park. Individuals and groups were invited to purchase commemorative bricks, and unbeknownst to anyone, one brick contained a secret message. The brick reads, "Break open your cold ones, toast the Padres, enjoy this championship organization." But if you take the first letter of every word, it spells out boycott Petco. Turns out the brick was purchased by People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, which believes the practices of pet seller Petco are cruel and deadly to animals. With us now in the studio, the PETA campaign coordinator, Dan Shannon, and from Hartford, Connecticut, ESPN.com sports business reporter, Darren Rovell. Good morning to you both.
Morning.
So, Dan, what do you have against Petco?
Well, Petco is a company, I mean, they're basically the Detroit Tigers of animal care. Okay, they have a really poor record on animal welfare. We've been getting complaints from employees and customers at Petco for 10 years about animals starving to death in their cages in these stores, being cannibalized by one another. Managers actually tell employees to take these animals and throw them in the freezer and have them freeze to death if they're sick, rather than take them to the vet. I mean, they can afford the naming right to the stadium, but they can't afford to take a gerbil to the vet when he gets sick. It's a little ridiculous.
So who came up with the idea to place the hidden message in the brick?
Well, we wanted to place just a straightforward message. We wanted to get a brick that just said, boycott Petco, but, you know, they caught on to that one and they wouldn't let us put it in. So we just came up with the anagram thing and just looked at it, and it took us a little while to figure out the code to it, but that's how we came up with it.
Darren, I know you found this story. How effective do you think the brick will be in getting their message across?
Well, from a publicity standpoint, obviously they've gotten that. Whether a passerby who's looking at a brick who sees that can decode it and then believe in the message. I mean, obviously, you'd have to figure out that that indeed is the boycott Petco brick. And then whether you're a Padres fan who would normally come to the stadium and then relate that you don't believe in Petco's practices, and that would actually get you to boycott Petco, I think that's whether this message is ultimately effective.
Dan, how much do you have to pay for the brick?
We only had to pay $200 for the brick, so it was basically a steal for us.
Why do you think it was money well spent?
Well, if you look at a company like Petco, I mean, the naming rights deal that they made alone with the Padres is about 5 times our annual budget. So we can't afford to compete with them one-on-one with in an advertising perspective. So we have to do sort of gimmicky little things like this in order to get our message out there. Like, we set up a website, for instance, at petcocruelty.com. These are the sorts of tactics that we need to use to get our message out there, because we can't afford to compete with them on an advertising standpoint.
Darren, what are the Padres going to do about the brick? Are they trying to remove it?
Well, the last time I spoke to the people at Petco, they talked to the Padres organization, obviously having spent a significant amount of money, $60 million for 22 years for this naming rights deal. The Padres were concerned. They talked to Petco, and Petco thought that the message was so disguised, the 12-word statement that might have, when you decoded things, come out to boycott Petco. But since it didn't specifically say that, at least right now, they're going to leave that brick.
Dan, what's PETA's ultimate goal here?
Well, we're hoping the Padres will actually use their relationship with Petco to try to get the company to clean up their act a little bit. You know, make some improvements in the way these animals are being treated, get them out of these filthy cages, and just give them a little bit of a better life. We're hoping that the Padres will, you know, see that this is basically the right thing to do. It's bad PR for them. It's bad PR for Petco to have this sort of thing continue. So we're hoping they'll get on board with us and help us out with this campaign.
Darren, do you think the Padres even care?
Well, I mean, that's certainly a question. I mean, obviously, from a fan standpoint, you know, I mean, will people actually relate to Petco's problems? The real question is, do fans care? Because when they're going to a stadium yet, I mean, do they even think of the company that has the naming rights? And, you know, so, you know, I'm not even sure. They do care about their relationship with Petco based on the fact that they did consult Petco when they found out about this, but I'm not sure. I think the Padres have to care whether their fans care, and I'm not sure where that is right now.
Well, Dan, we have a statement by Petco that they released. It says, "Petco constantly strives to provide a safe, healthy, and humane environment for companion animals in our stores. The company remains perplexed by PETA's agenda and tactics. Their actions demonstrate how desperate they are to generate publicity themselves." You want to comment there?
Yeah, well, if Petco's got an animal welfare policy, it's about as strict as baseball's steroid policy. I mean, in the past 2 weeks, we've gotten 47 complaints about Petco stores where cruelty to animals is taking place, including a place in Fairfax, Virginia, where a store manager was going around vacuuming up parakeets in a vacuum cleaner just for fun, and also where parakeets were out on the floor with a disease called psittacosis, which is a disease that's fatal to birds and actually can be transmitted to human beings and can be fatal to us as well. We've got little kids in this store playing with these birds that have this disease. You know, we're just hoping that people will check out PetcoCruelty.com to learn about the issues here. We're hoping the Padres and their fans will stop supporting this company that's doing these horrible things to animals.
Hey, Dan, Darren, how beneficial is it for a company to name a stadium after them?
Well, you know, that's still up in the air, despite the fact that companies are spending $3 to $7 million a year for some of these deals. And Petco has told me that within the past month, they've gotten 100 million mentions in the press alone. Whether that mention then translates to people coming into the stores is very debatable. People have to, one, know that it's Petco Park, two, feel that Petco has a relationship with the Padres, and then three, feel that that relationship's beneficial enough that they'll actually then go and walk into the store and make a purchase based on their relationship with both Petco and the Padres. So I'm not sure if that one-to-one sales relationship is happening, despite the fact that there's 100 million mentions out there. How many sales are they really doing?
All right, Darren, Dan, thanks so much for talking with us this morning.
Thanks for having
me. We should note we invited people from the Padres organization to come in today to talk about this, and they declined. Petco paid $60 million to purchase the naming rights of the stadium for 22 years. We're back with more Cold Pizza after this.
Cold Pizza, brought to you.